sacred glen. Truly your blessed foundling. That glen contains the true nectar, the most precious sacrament. Each drop holds both transcendence and transfigurement. Rare is the soul brave enough to extract such an offering. I'm afraid I'm no longer fit for such work. The rite of extraction requires deeply pious hands. Though perhaps deeply blasphemous hands would do.
We stole from those thieves. There was never enough tar to go around. It was wasted on them anyways. We knew what it was. Its full potential. Why dilute it? But we were punished all the same. In time, my ruined face peeled away. Her form faded into something like fog. Something trapped between realms. With the tar throbbing in my belly, I see her completely. Each movement creates a swarm of copies. They ripple out from her, following their own whims. Some collide and join together, while others split apart, forming new copies. A reflection of reflections spreading out from her. The Nexus, yet also indistinguishable.
Don't overindulge.
A smoke choked my vision, and tears welled in my eyes. The world itself burned white hot, but beneath it all, there was nothing. No monsters, no gods, only oblivion. The consecrated fires revealed cinders and shadows, yet I strained to see more. Surely these sages offered more than the assurances of annihilation.
Yes. Slowly now. I see. Yes, taste the truth. Very well. overindulge.
I hid my disfigurement beneath my cowl and slipped away. I was delirious when I reached the seat of infinity. Did I dream up this kind soul among the cherubs and the faceless masters? She welcomed me without flinching and offered nourishment. Had my throat always been this parched?
Yes.
I'm unrecognizable. A ghoul. Or perhaps a ghost, haunting this empty household. But I'm not unworthy of pity. Not yet, at least. A merchant dared to speak to me. He was a hideous fellow, but a kindred soul, I suppose. He mentioned a colony of sorts where my misfortune would be cured. He did not name its price.
That's... You've brought the fog with you.
Sacred land holds but a fraction of its potency.